Greetings, YouTube. Sir Daniel 1975 back again. Haven't been to do a video in a bit. I've been having trouble with getting the recording right on my videos here. So far, seems okay right now. Let's show off the new ship here. This is the Tier 6 Avenger, not Arbiter, though I did get the Tier 6 Arbiter, which is a Sea Store ship. But I went and I got the Fleet version, which I believe they call it the Avenger, as well as the Tier 5 versions. So, it's a pretty sweet ship. And basically, it's the Avenger with an extra Lieutenant Commander spot in Tactical. Whereas, there's a Lieutenant Commander in Tactical in the Tier 5 Avenger, and then you've got a Lieutenant Universal. Now you get an extra Lieutenant Commander Universal, which is great. And in the Tier 6 versions, the given Lieutenant Commander Tactical is also a Intel hybrid seating. So, anyway, I wanted to get the Fleet version because, I wanted that extra console right here in the Science. And of course, I wanted to get the Sea Store version because I really wanted to get that mastery ability that you get here, which is emergency weapon cycle, which benefits emergency powered weapons, which is I went and I got the emergency powered weapons 3. Actually, I crafted it, I believe, and it's pretty cool. It's wonderful. And then I went and I got the directed energy modulation 3. So I'm doing a different commander engineering build than I normally do. Let's see here. And then I did quite a few variations on what to do with this Lieutenant Commander Tactical Intel Hybrid. Let me go over to him so you can see. And I use my Jumbat R for this. I'm going to use the Chemosite Laced Weaponry. Even though it's been nerfed, it's still really good. Even with the nerfing, it is still really good. Okay. I went with Override Subsystem Safeties 2. It's one of my favorite abilities. I actually have Override Subsystem Safeties 3, but in playing around with this particular seating, I have come to like Torpedo Spread 3 because Torpedo Spread 3 is freaking awesome. And that is just the way it is. So, there's that. Anyway, let's go back to traits real fast. Let me see. Personal space traits. And I'm just going to wave over them. I'm not going to read them out. If you want to see what they are, you can pause the video and read what each thing is if you're not using any of these. So far, this video recording is sounding pretty good. This is actually the second time I'm running this. Last time, the levels were all messed up. There was all sorts of interference, clipping. Yeah, of course, this is my favorite Starship trait right now that I have, Overwhelming Force. It is incredible. People not using it, not using beam overload, or not using torpedo high yield, I'm sorry, you just don't get it. It's really awesome. There's that. Oh, and space reputation. Yeah, and I've got my build here set up for maximum torpedo in your face damage. So let's see here. And I think that's the only real torpedo damage. What are these? That's just boosting. That's just that. Okay, and what is this? Killings. Okay. And intelligence, one of the things I like most in intelligence are all these space flanking abilities. So if you are have outflanked the enemy and then you've got all these torpedo, it's pretty darn devastating. So, all right, skills. Okay, and what else can I show real fast? Cluster, active space. Just let you see what those are. Yeah, okay. So you can see. Alright. Now, I guess the best thing to do is quickly show the space gear. Some things have been upgraded. Again, if you want to know what these are, you can pause the video and read it yourself. I'm not going to read all this stuff out loud. Yeah, I am using the Iconium Resistance set. And yes, and if you get the this set, try and upgrade the warp core to get that amp mod. This is to be used with the neutronic torpedo. Yes, I like to use two torpedoes. So I've got it kind of rigged for critical. Okay. Now that we have seen that, and let's see, the ship costume that I'm using is mostly the Arbiter, but I'm using the Avenger pylons because I like the nacelles up a little bit higher. Let's show you what, without the HUD on, I did bump my graphics up to maximum. This is the best that my card does. I don't have as nice a card as some of you all, but it's still not too bad, not too shabby. It's a good ship. If you're curious as to what the Iconian shield looks like on this, and it does, looks pretty darn cool, but I like the skin that comes with this this ship. I think it's pretty darn good looking. So anyway, my next thing I will do is take this sucker into battle. You can follow me over to one of these Romulan sector patrols. It's a bit laggy because I threw the graphics up, but I want you all to be able to see how good this is, or the potential of how good it can be. All right. Actually, this ship looks really great. Here in sector space. right. And just if you're curious, this is an, I've got my difficulty set at advanced. If I haven't changed it, it should still be set at advanced. Yeah, it's at advanced. Okay. Yes, yes, you see, took out most of them in one set of volleys. Yeah, that was an ideal situation. It doesn't always happen. Yeah, see, 47. Okay, almost 48. Of course, I've had better crits on other build things, but I think I'm getting a way more consistent high crits with this build. Yeah, that was nuts. Yeah, two of the crits in there was 30-something K. It's just 28k, and there's just a lot of big crits going on. I mean, this is a really, really great ship, and a great, I think it's a fantastic build. And I'm sure there's people out there who have much better builds going on. Obviously, there's people who are doing over 100k easy. I don't know, I might be doing 100k now on this ship. I'm not sure. I don't use a parser, so I have no idea. You know, and part of the reason why I'm doing a system patrol, because I want people to get an idea of really what I'm doing without any interference from other players. So sometimes when you do these PvE queues, you just, you know, you get somebody in there that just does like five times as much as you do. You know, you're doing quite a bit. It ends up looking like you don't do anything at all. I see that was a massive crit right there too. Yeah. And take in mind, like I said, folks, this is a advanced queue. Not the advanced, it's the hardest. Obviously, there's... the elite. And this ship is just doing such a powerful job on on the advanced that I am tempted to possibly do a video with this build in the elite, just so you can see, you know, how effective this ship is. You know, and of course I had other ships and stuff that I could do this particular system patrol in an advanced, and I've done elites too with other ships, you know, like the Benthon and even the tier 5U fleet Avenger have done stuff like that, but not quite as effective as this, where I think the match went pretty quickly. So, like I said, I mean, this ship's just, it is sweet, it is nice, it is very powerful. It's a 5-star ship, in my opinion. In fact, I would give it like more than 5 stars. You know, but that just sounds kind of ridiculous. But it is a really solid ship. It's very powerful. It has a great look to it, especially with this Arbiter skin. And with mixing it with the Avenger pylons. In my opinion, I think it gives an impression of the Enterprise E a little bit, which is pretty, dare I say it, badass. And then you're getting an Intel seating. I mean, you can do more Intel abilities than what I'm using. We all know that there's some great abilities out there, but I mixed around with them, and this is what I like the most, is just using one Intel ability. But I wanted to definitely have some sort of override subsystem safeties. That was what I loved the most about when I was using the Benthon, was I had that ability on my Lieutenant Science hybrid Intel person, bridge officer. And so then I got some fantastic, you know, crits with that. And while combining all that with this, it's just incredible, especially with Emergency Power to Weapons 3. It's just unreal. So, and of course, the bridge, an engineer has good power levels to begin with, and then when you throw in this EPS power transfer, I mean, all your power shoots through the roof on that too. So, this is, I mean, people diss playing as an engineer, but I think people should probably start considering to play as an engineer, because I think I am comparable to a lot of tactical players with this, with the way I'm got this character built, and with the ship I'm using and the gear. It's pretty darn good. So anyway, like I said, it's a great ship. I love it. And I think y'all should try getting at least the C-Store version. It is completely worth it. And I think the that weapon cycle ability is great for emergency power to weapons. And anyway, thanks for watching, and catch y'all on the flip side.